Gasoline prices are now above $4 a gallon in 9 states and Washington, D.C. That's triple the number of states now paying more than $4 a gallon since just the 9th of March. Here to discuss the administration's energy policy and a great deal more is Congressman Louie Gohmert, member of the House Natural Resources Committee and Judiciary Committee. And Congressman, great to have you here.
Great to be talking to you, Louie.
Let's start with Obamacare. The arguments, as you know, begin this coming Monday. This legislative achievement of this administration, its signature, nothing said today. Your reaction?
Well, I wouldn't have put it past them to have a birthday celebration to try to tell the Supreme Court, you got to back us on this, but maybe they've had enough activity behind the scenes that they're not worried. But you may have known the Solicitor General currently has been saying, gee, maybe it's a tax, not a tax. Mm-hmm. He's taken positions on this, and it makes you go, so was Kagan so incompetent she never gave the president advice on his signature piece of legislation? And but that's another issue for another day.
There are a lot of issues here, and turning now to energy. With gasoline sitting at $3.89 a gallon now, and the president saying there's no silver bullet, no magic solution, nothing that can be done, your thoughts?
There is an intermediate silver bullet, and it's not the strategic petroleum reserves. The fact is, speculators are educated gamblers, and they look at what's happening in this country and around the world. And I know I got great respect for Bill O'Reilly, and he said, well, obviously it's not supply and demand because the demand's down. The demand's down in this country, mm-hmm. but every year but one, worldwide, the demand has increased. And we are part of the global economy, and it's only the middle section of the country that uses the West Texas Intermediate crude as their benchmark. The East and West Coast uses international. So
now Bill is, however, in my opinion, exactly right in saying that it is not a matter of supply and demand. Demand right now is at a 15-year low. Our supplies are still running high. We are exporting gasoline.
But the speculation comes from the fact of what are we doing about it. And we had Salazar recently before Natural Resources, and I don't know if you remember, Lou, but in January of 2009,
the Secretary of Interior,
January of 2009, 2 months before the Bush administration had let leases, I think 77 leases, Utah, it would have been vast amounts. We're told there's maybe a trillion, maybe 3 trillion barrels of oil there. And Salazar came in 2 months later and said, he's sending back the checks, canceling those leases. I demanded to know if he realized when he said it was a midnight deal that it was a 7-year process. 7 years, Lou, to get those leases in a position to let. And so I asked the head of the BLM this last week, have you sent a thank you note to President Bush for what you're doing now?
You know, we just put up a chart there, and if we could, we should show that again. And that is drilling permits approved for federal lands dropping down again. We've been sitting here looking
about half of what Clinton did.
Well, it's about as a matter of fact, they're down 38% under this administration for federal lands.
But of course,
Clinton had raised them by 58%. We saw George Bush increase those permits on federal lands by 116%. This president is talking about oil production, but he's actually given approval for 38%.
Right, production's down on federal land.
Right.
And the production that's being done is a result of permits that the Bush administration led. You and I were talking before the show about his comment, we only have 2% of the oil. And you've got to keep in mind, I'm surprised you don't realize this, but 48 points.
Don't ever be surprised when I don't realize.
Well, when anybody from Washington quotes statistics, 48.6% of the time, they're just made up.
Well, let me tell you what, I just made one up. I said 38% fewer permits, and it's 36, so I want to get that straight.
Okay.
I'm slow, but I get there.
Yeah.
Congressman, it's great to have you.
Lou, it's always good to talk to you, and really, thank you. This ought to be a time of renaissance. All the energy we found in the last 5 years, the economy ought to be just going sky high.
I couldn't agree.
It breaks my heart that this president is causing people to hurt.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more, and I'll be honest with you. I can't believe that these Republican candidates for president are focusing on this like a laser. Congressman, always good to have you with us.
It's so good to be with you. Thank you.
Coming up here in just a few minutes. I'll